line art, my Achilles heel in my art process. Line art takes me forever, but I do love the look of clean lines, so inevitably I find myself drawing line art. Thankfully, Clip Studio Paint has a bunch of features to make line art much easier for me. So for beginners unfamiliar with drawing line art in Clip Studio Paint, here are some ways I like to use things like vector layers, border effects, and more to speed up and improve my line art drawing process. So let's begin with what is the difference between vector and raster layers in Clip Studio Paint. Firstly, vector layers are made up of connecting points, lines, and polygons, and they can be infinitely scaling and use vector-only tools within Clip Studio Paint, and this is better for line art in an illustration process. Meanwhile, raster layers are made up of colored grids, and scaling results in pixelated looks due to the grid system. This is better for coloring, painting, and blending. Within Clip Studio Paint, there are a lot of great features that you can use when using vector layers. I'll start by making a new vector layer and start by drawing some random squiggly lines. Here, I'd like to first explain how vectors work in Clip Studio Paint. So vectors are really just a bunch of points connected mathematically on the layer itself. Firstly, there are a lot of points here when making a random stroke, as you can see. To reduce the number of control points on a vector line, all you need to do is go to Simplify Vector Line and use this pen tool to draw where you want there to be less control points. This will simplify the amount of control points, and then as you can see now, there's much less control points in this section compared to over here in this section. Now, when doing vector lines, you can see these points are connected in a somewhat... If you'd like the shape to be straight instead of curved, you can go under Tool Property, Control Point, and then Switch Corner to switch between this being a curved or straight edge. Now the connecting lines between these two points are straight instead of curved. You can switch it back just by clicking it on it again. Next, move control points will be able to move where the points are on the canvas. This will affect how the line looks and how it interacts with the other points connecting to it. You can see how even though I'm moving this point in particular, it also affects the curvature of the other points along this line. This is because the line itself is curved, but as mentioned earlier, you can switch corner here. And then if this is straight, moving this control point will not affect the points over here because it's straight instead of curved. This is due to the math of it, which I don't completely understand, but you can play around with vector layers and see how it works for you. Now I've quickly drawn a headshot to demonstrate some more features in Clip Studio Paint's vector modes. One of the features I use most often in drawing line art in Clip Studio Paint is the thicken and narrow features under Subtool Correct Line Width. You can choose to either thicken or narrow the width of the line and make it thinner or thicker. You can adjust the amount of thickness or thinness it'll add or subtract from the width of the line. Let's say I want to add just about 1 pixel of thickness in certain areas of this line art. Now whatever I select will be highlighted by the green, and any points within the green will have the thickness adjusted by 1 pixel. Let's say I made it too thick in some of the parts, I can narrow it, and let's say I want it narrow by half a pixel or so, and I can just do that, and it will narrow it. Let's say I want to adjust the thickness of the whole line, and then not just whatever is selected here under the green when I draw this. I can do that by scrolling down to Process Whole Line, and then when this is checked, whatever I highlight with this pen, the whole line will have its thickness changed. You might be able to see this clearer if I use straighter lines to demonstrate this. If I have the process whole line box checked, I can highlight any point on this line and it will process the whole line to make it thicker or thinner. Let's make it way thicker and test like that. As you can see, just by drawing on one point, it'll adjust the whole thickness of the entire stroke and line. Meanwhile, if this is not checked, wherever I highlight, only the points in this highlighted area will be affected. You can see this better if you go to Object and click on the line, and you'll be able to see that here, all points have its width affected. Meanwhile here, only the points where I was highlighting it will have its thickness adjusted. You can also use the redraw vector line or redraw vector line width tools to correct some of the lines you've already drawn. For example, let's say I don't like how this line is drawn. I can correct that by just redrawing it. And this will adjust the position of all points on this line and stroke. Now, as you can see, some parts of this look pretty messy. One of my favorite parts of drawing lines on vector is being able to use the vector eraser. You can check this box to determine how you're erasing different lines and points. For example, let's say I want to erase up to the intersection. Here you can see the hair not quite line up, and I can just erase these two points and then it will automatically calculate the intersection of the points and the lines and erase up to that point. Now let's say I don't want it to erase up to intersection, let's say I want it to erase the whole line, so this will remove the entire line. I can click on the whole line icon, and now when I erase whatever I erase, it'll also remove the entire line associated with that. Or you can click on Erase Touched Areas, and this will erase the points and lines associated with whatever you're erasing. So now if you go to Object again, you'll see that it cuts off the line a bit, and then whatever is erased is removed. However, if you don't check Vector Eraser, what this instead does is make a new vector line which is set to Erase or Transparent. You can see that by going to Object, and now you can see that the stroke of eraser lines I just did is its own vector line, which can be adjusted further depending on what you want to do with it. This also applies if you use a regular pen and set the color to transparent pixels. Now whatever I erase will be another vector line. When you aren't using the vector eraser to properly remove the points or vector lines associated with the layer, then you have to be careful to not merge layers unintentionally. For example, if I have another vector layer underneath that and make a line, say, around here. Now, if I merge the layers, you can see that the vector eraser is also affecting the layer beneath it when it's merged. However, if it's not merged on the same layer, then it will have no effect on the below layers, as you can see here. So, if vector layers have so much features, why not use it for everything in the illustration process? Well, that's because vector layers and raster layers are fundamentally different in how they function. Vector layers might be better for line art, however, they are much less suitable for painting and coloring. For example, on a vector layer, you do have a lot of control over lines and being able to erase up to intersection, however you please. If you wanted to blend two colors together, it won't be possible due to how vectors use points and polygons. If I try to use the blend subtool, you can see that it'll just take whatever color I'm currently using and apply that here. If I go to Object and try to move this around, you'll see I'm moving around points and lines instead of actually blending the colors. Meanwhile, if I do that in a raster layer, while I might not have the same tools as vector to erase up to intersection, when I draw and blend colors, I can use the blend tool normally and blend colors as I would regularly. Also, when painting, this is nicer because I have access to being able to stretch colors around and have more control over how I paint colors. If I tried that on the vector layer, it would instead take it as different points and lines and not be able to merge or blend colors at all. Also with vector layers, you won't have access to being able to lock transparent pixels. So if you like to color your line art, you would have to either rasterize this layer or make a clipping layer above that to color the line art. Now, before getting into the line art demonstration, I'd first like to talk about line detail. Before getting into actually lining the illustration, I need to first think about what is the context of the drawing that I'm lining. Most of the time when I do line art, I draw the line art for illustration, meaning the lines will be colored and also have other layer effects and other things added on top of it. Because of this, certain times I will line it more detailed in areas where I feel like there will be a lot of viewer focus, and spend less time and less detail lining things that will be out of focus, or lines that will be over darker colors beneath it. If I was instead doing line art for a comic, I would maybe spend more time on darker values and high contrast lines. Or if the illustration I'm drawing has characters very far from the viewer, then I know I won't need to put too much detail in the lines because it'll be too small to see for the viewer. Now, what you don't want to do is spend a lot of time drawing very minute details that the viewer won't see, especially if it's a little bit further from the camera, or if the color beneath the lines is a very dark shade. For example, in this commission I did, I spent a lot of time lining this, however most of the work I did is not actually visible in the final product. So generally, before lining, you should first understand the context of the drawing. Before getting into the actual lining part, think about the position of the character or object you're drawing, and how far it is from the viewer or camera. Close-ups require more attention to detail, and further objects can be sketchier and have less attention to detail, since it'll be further away from the camera slash viewer. So for this drawing demonstration, the drawing I'm working on today will have the character be somewhat close to the viewer, so I'll be able to put some detail where it'll be more visible, and maybe have less line art detail in areas where there will be darker colors underneath the lines. Before getting into the actual line art, Clip Studio Paint Asset Store has a lot of great brushes that you can check out yourself. Just by searching line on the asset store, You can browse a bunch of free and paid assets that people have generously put on the asset store to experiment with what kind of line art style you like. For this demonstration, I'll be starting off with just using the default mapping pen. However, if you're not happy with the brush you chose when drawing line art, no worries. As long as you drew it on a vector layer, you'll be able to change the brush you use at any time later in the process. I'll show you how later in this tutorial. Before getting to the actual line art, I like changing the layer color of the sketch under layer property, going to effect, and then change layer color. By default, this changes the layer color to light blue, which I like, but you can also change it to any other color. I lower the opacity a little bit, that way I can actually properly see what I'm lining and focus on the line art instead of getting kind of confused by the sketch sometimes. When lining hair, it's nice to use longer strokes for the look of a more smooth and wind blowing through hair feel. I also like to add some extra details by just adding a few lines here and there to give the illusion of thicker hair. These are just lines that I add kind of on the edges of the perimeter or border of the actual hair shape, and can add a little bit more depth to the thickness of the hair. Also, if I were drawing really long hair and I didn't want to line the whole thing, another thing I could do is go to the border effect and draw using a white layer and make sure that I click this, adjust the thickness of the edges to what I want the thickness of the line to be, and set the edge color to black. Here, I'll draw in. Here, let's pretend I have some long, luscious hair. I'll quickly draw in some random strokes. You don't have to look too great, and generally block in where I want the hair to go. Now, I'll also use a regular black pen and draw more line detail here. Since I used a white color to block in the shape of the hair, I can go into Edit and Convert Brightness to Opacity. Oh, and now you'll see that actually I forgot a step, so you should not do what I just did. Instead, right-click on this layer, click Rasterize. This will remove the border effect, being an effect on the layer property itself, and kind of making this into one flat layer. Now, if I draw something new using a white brush, there won't be a border effect applied to this. Here, now, I can finally go into Edit and Convert Brightness to Opacity. This will remove the white from the inside of the lines where I was blocking out the hair. I can erase some parts, and then now I have a little bit longer hair. But that's not my character design, so let's hide this layer. I'll make a new layer, add a border effect on it, and then once again, I'll make sure the edge color is black. I'll reduce the thickness of the edges and use a white brush to add in some highlights. Now let's continue lining. It's nice to go in and add some thickness to areas with shadow, so it's more visible over darker colored objects. Then again, liner all done at around the same thickness also has its own charm. Honestly, it's up to you. Many artists have their own different styles of lining. You can play around with what you like and find out what works best for you when lining characters or objects. Now, when lining this, I realized I accidentally made one of the line art layers a raster layer on accident. In order to convert between vector and raster layers, you can go to Layer and then Convert Layer. Here, you'll be able to rename the layer, change the expression color, the blending mode, and also change the type. Currently, it's a raster layer, and I'd like to change it to vector layer. So I'll click OK. And as you can see, when converting between raster and vector, sometimes the line art quality gets lost. However, if I wanted to convert between a vector to a raster layer, then usually the quality isn't actually lost. Here I can go under Layer, Convert Layer, and change this from vector layer to raster layer. When I do that, you see no visible changes to the line art, but actually when you try to change the width now, you can see it doesn't actually work and correctly change the thickness of the line art width as it would if it was a vector layer. So generally, it's easier to change from vector to raster than the other way around. Now, I'll just go ahead and lower the opacity of the layer I accidentally drew on raster and draw it again on a vector layer. Alright, so now that I'm mostly done with line art, let's hide the sketch layer. Now, let's say that I don't actually want this to be lined using a very clean brush. Let's say I want to use a different brush and wish I lined it with a more textured brush. Because all the lines are drawn in vector, I can change the property of it without too much issue. First, I'll go ahead and merge all the vector layers and combine them into one layer. Now that they're all on one layer, I'll go into Object and select all the lines that I want to convert into a different brush. Now, I could do this manually by shift-clicking all the lines, but I drew a lot of lines and that would take a lot of time. So instead of doing that, I can go under Object, click the Operation of Transparent Part dropdown, and here click Select Area by Dragging. Now, when I click and drag, you'll see a box show up. Any vector lines within this box will be automatically selected. Let's say I wanted the line art to actually be using the Supreme Pencil by Yuriky on Clip Studio Paint Assets Store. This is also linked in the description below if you'd like to download it. In order to add that pencil to the presets, I'll click on the Supreme Pencil brush, then I'll click on the subtool detail, which is the wrench icon. Here I'll click on brush shape, and see under current brush shape, I'll add the shape to presets. Now this will be in my presets. Now going back to object, and making sure that the select area by dragging is still clicked, I'll select the line art. I'll make sure I'm on the vector layer and select all the line art points. This will highlight all the points. And here I can go into the wrench tool again, which opens up the subtool detail, and then click on Supreme Pencil. Here I'll click Apply Brush Shape and X out of this. But now you can see that this is lined using the Supreme Pencil instead of the earlier brush. Using some of the vector tools we covered earlier, including the correct line width, you can also correct line width quickly by just coloring over the whole thing, maybe making it a little bit more thicker and visible. Now this is drawn using a textured brush, and I didn't have to redraw it manually. Now, let's say instead of using a crayon brush, I wanted it to use a slightly textured brush, but not exactly crayon brush. Let's try this out using the Zari Pen made by on Clip Studio Assets. This will also be linked in the description. Using the same method, I'll make sure I'm selecting the brush, going under the wrench icon to open up the subtool details, going under brush shape, add this to presets, close this, then go to the line art layer, go under object, click and drag to select all the lines, and then once again going under the wrench icon and then clicking brush shape and applying the brush shape of the new pen. That's what that looks like. So using these methods, you can see that I got three different results using three different brushes by just using the select object tool and changing the brush tip. But I'll go back to my regular line art from the first layer. So before I finish up, I'll go ahead and add some more details so that the line art looks a little bit better on its own, just for the YouTube thumbnail. Now that I finished adding some contrasting details and color, I've finished the line art. Thank you for watching, and I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would appreciate if you could give this video a like, and subscribe if you'd like to see more from my channel. If you have questions, or would like me to cover a specific topic next, feel free to leave a comment. I'll see you next time. Bye bye!